Okay, so I have a great tweak here for people that really want to push and get maximum performance out of their 8th generation core i5, i7, so the 8250 and the 8550U CPUs. You can push them to perform just like the core i7-7700HQ. Now, this is a quad-core 45-watt processor that is typically found in gaming laptops, so it's quite a feat here that we're able to get now this particular CPU, which is 15 watts, to perform with that kind of speed there. So the maximum turbo of the CPU that I have here, the i5-8250, is 3.4 gigahertz. Now, in order to do this little tweak here, we need to download Intel's Extreme Tuning Utility. So download that, install it, then reboot your system. Once you have rebooted, open it up and go over to the Advanced Tuning, the Core panel here. And there's a couple of settings here we want to change in order to get the maximum benefit out of the CPU to really push it hard. So go along to the Turbo Max Power here. Now, by default, this will be on 15. That's the default stock setting. So we want to increase this to something like 35 or even 40 watts here is what I'm going to go with. So this, in turn, will what it allow the CPU to do is consume more power, hold those turbos at 3.4 on all four cores for as long as it wants. This is how it can perform just like the i7-7700HQ. So we go up to the core voltage offset. This can also be set to minus 0.1 volts. So this is undervolting it to help lower temperatures a little bit. It will also probably help out with battery life too, slightly. Now, mileage will vary on this particular setting. Some CPUs can only go to 0.09, others could do 0.115. If you get a blue screen, you have undervolted too much, so just tone it back on that. So apply that, and now you can see that what in turn happens is it's holding that boost. You can see here, this is a previous test that I did, holding those cores at the 3.4, and the cooling, at least on this particular laptop, which is Xiaomi's Mi Notebook Pro, didn't go over 60 degrees with my ambient temperatures here of 25 degrees Celsius. So impressive results. This is great. This is amazing. This means I can encode my 4K videos so much faster. Now, the benefit of how fast this is really, well, I did a few benchmarks to get a gauge on just what kind of performance we're seeing. So running Cinebench R15, I got a score here of 571 CB. Okay, that's not too bad considering the type of processor, but it's not really that impressive. Now, with that TPD increase to 40 watts, it's gone all the way up to 736, which is a massive 29% boost there, and that actually got a better score than my gaming laptop with the i7-7000HQ, so really good results on that. But we can also go a step further and overclock the GPU. So this model has the NVIDIA MX150, and what I've done here is add 1 gigahertz to the RAM. Now, you're probably thinking that's a huge amount to add to the RAM, but they tend to underclock the RAM to the spec of the RAM. It can actually perform a lot faster, but they do that for battery saving. So what I'm going to do here is just add that, and I've tested it out. There are zero artifacts when gaming and pushing it hard. I don't see any glitches or anything, so that's a safe setting. And you can also tweak up the core clock here. I've only put 60. You can put up to 61, 100 even, but you don't really get much benefit from that at all. So that in turn boosts performance, and I ran some tests here again. So this is the stock score of Heaven, 587. And now once that was overclocked the GPU and the CPU as well, it is now 770, which is not an amazing score. This is not a gaming laptop, but even so, that went up around 31% boost there, which is really impressive too. Now, in another benchmark, this is Firestrike stock score, 2916. Then with the boost, with the overclocking, it goes up to 3,364. So that's only a 15% increase on that one, so not so impressive. Now, another thing you can do is in the NVIDIA control panel is make sure you set the power management mode here to maximum performance. That'll ensure you're going to get the maximum power use out of the GPU even when you're not on power. So it perform on battery just like it was on power, giving you maximum frames per second. Another recommendation there. So there we go. With those settings there, we can get the CPU to perform really impressively, as good as that i7-7700HK, which is, to me, that is pretty amazing. And there seems to be really no negative impact on this, at least on my model. The cooling can handle it, which is great. But if you're gaming with that tweak, I'm not too sure. You probably shouldn't do that tweak when gaming at the same time. Then it will get pretty hot, but just keep an eye on thermals. So your mileage will vary from unit to unit, different laptops as well, like the Dell Inspirons that have the same CPU. Thank you so much for watching this video here, and best of luck with your undervolting, adding more wattage to the TDP setting, and overclocking your GPU. Now we'll be back with more videos on the Mi Notebook Pro here. I'll have a gaming review coming up. Also in my full review, I'll test out video editing, 4K video editing and encoding, and many other things, including battery life and all that. So I hope to see you back then. Bye for now.